Hello guys, I am Paul McWhorter from TopTechBoy.com and we are here today to learn Fusion 360 or die trying. We're here with lesson number 7 in this series, and what we will be learning today is to design some 3D printable nuts and bolts. Okay, so enough of this nonsense introduction. Let me get out of your way. I need you to fire up Fusion 360. I need you to pour yourself a nice cup of coffee and get ready to learn to make some 3D printable nuts and bolts. Okay, so let's come in Fusion 360. Let's start by doing a new design. Okay, and then we're going to want to create a sketch, and say we will say create sketch. I like to draw in the XY plane. That is the red green plane, and it actually does kind of matter, because if you sketch in the 3D plane, or if you sketch in the XY plane, chances are when you export it to your slicer software, when you do the 3D print from Fusion 360, lot better chance that that thing is oriented in the proper print direction. Just a little tip there. Okay, so I'm going to click on this plane. I am in the red green plane, which is the XY plane, and the fundamental shape which we are going to start with will also, let me just tell you, we are going to be doing a nut and a bolt, and the fundamental shape that we're going to start with is a hexagon. A hexagon is a polygon, so I come up here and I select polygon, and I'm going to do an inscribed polygon. I come here, I hover over the origin, I click, then I drag out, and this is kind of important for what we're going to do. You need to align the corner with the x-axis, and you see if you get near, it'll snap to it, so that is now snapped to the x-axis, and you can see that I'm already set on 6 sides right here. You can see right there I'm set on 6 sides. If you're not on 6 sides, now would be a good time to set that at 6 sides. Otherwise, come and snap your cursor to the x-axis and click. Okay, now we need to dimension. How do we dimension? We tap D on the keyboard, and I want to dimension from the offsetting or the parallel sides, and I am thinking that I want that to be 25. Okay, that will be a nice size. Now what do we need? We're going to need a circle, so we are going to come up and select circle, or you could just type C. I want a center circle, hover over the origin, let it snap to it, click once, drag out, click again. Now what do? We dimension, so I click D, I point at the edge of the circle, I drag out, and I want the diameter of that circle to be 15. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. We are making a lot of progress here. We are making a lot of progress. Okay, so now I'm going to, I'm going to do something I normally don't do. You know, you guys know that I really don't like to offset or copy and paste, because when you do that, a lot of times it doesn't bring the constraints over, or it brings the constraints over in a surprising or unusual way that can sometimes mess you up. But this is a simple enough thing. Boom, it's going to be easier to copy and paste. Plus, you can kind of see how to do it. I do like to give myself a point to go to, so I am going to create a line, L. I tap L, I hover over the origin, click once, come out here, click again, click the check mark, then I'm going to hit escape to get out of that crazy tool, line tool, hover over the line, right mouse click, make it a construction line, a normal construction, and that way it's a feature, it's a marker, it's not a physical line. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to drag over all of this and select it, right mouse click, move copy. Okay, and what I'm going to do here is, because I could go point to point, I could go point to point and say take this point and put it at this point and it would move it, but it wouldn't lock it to that point. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to scoot it over a little bit, if it will let me scoot. Oh my goodness, let's try that again. Okay, let's just see here. We are going to copy, click off, we are going to paste, and then we are going to move. Okay, don't know why it didn't like it the first time. And then I'm going to click OK. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say I want this point coincident with that point. So I get the coincident tool, say take the center of this and make it coincident with that, and it did not. Oh yeah, it moved it the other way. It wasn't what I was expecting, but that's because I don't guess I have dimensioned this. So I need to say dimension, and I need to come here and dimension that line, and then I can say like 35. Okay, that looks good. Now everything is kind of constrained like I want it. Okay, so that looks good. So let me just say again, I think I was talking a little fast there, that I don't want to have anything that's just out floating around. And so I try to be very deliberate. This assembly or this sketch is locked to this center point, and this center point is a certain fixed distance away from this. So nothing's floating around. And not having things float around kind of ensure that as you edit things or you customize things, you don't end up with unexpected behavior. All right, let's go ahead and start doing our extrusions. And what I will do is I will try to start with this one. This will be the bolt. This will be the nut. I like to start on the inside. So let me click here and let me say extrude. And I am thinking that 40 will be a good distance to extrude. So 40, okay, that looks pretty good. And it always annoys me after you extrude, it turns your sketches off. But just come under sketches, click the light bulb, it will turn them back on. Just one of those little tips. Now I'm going to select this. I'm going to click shift and select this, and I am going to extrude again. And this time I will extrude 15. Okay. Boom. We are really looking good. We are going great. All right. So now what I need to do is I need to add the threads. So I'm going to come up and say create threads. And then the first thing it wants to know is where do you want to put it? What face do you want to put it on? Well, I want to put it on the inside face. So I click on the inside face. Very important. You get excited. Look, I've got threads. But what it did was it drew a picture of threads. It didn't actually put threads there. If you want something that is 3D printable, this is what is key. You have to not have a picture of threads. You have to say model the threads. And when you do that, it actually for real creates the threads. Now you can customize your threads here, but I am not a mechanical engineer and I don't understand all this stuff real well. I know if I use their recommended kind of selected one, they're usually about the right size, and then I just make sure that I'm consistent throughout the project. So we're going to say okay. We are going to do that again. We are going to say create, and we are going to create threads. And I'm going to do it here. Kind of just a neat thing. I'm not going to do this, but you don't have to go full length. You know, you could just go partially. I mean, it's kind of neat how you could do different things like that. But we're going to go full length for this, and we are going to model it like we said we should. And then we're going to click OK. Boom. Look at that, man. We are making huge progress here. In fact, you could stop right now and print it if you wanted to. But the one thing I don't like is I don't like these sharp edges. OK, I really don't like these sharp edges. And so what I want to do, I'm going to show you how to put a chamfer around that. And this will probably take another 5 minutes, but it's just sort of a neat little touch that you can put on these things. But to do that, I am going to need to sketch in a different plane. And right now I'm going to turn these bodies off, or at least I'm going to turn that body off so that I can select the plane that I want to draw in. So I'm going to say sketch, and I'm going to say create a sketch. Ask which do you want to do? Well, I want to go in the XZ plane. Okay, the XZ plane, which would be the red blue plane, which would be this one. Okay, and that for some reason is not what I was expecting. And so let's go back and say undo. All right, so I want in the, man, I really think that is what I want. So let me turn, let me try this one more time. I got an unexpected result there. So I'm going to say create sketch, and I want the red, blue. Okay, I want the red, blue. That is the red blue. That is what I want. Boom. And now I'm going to turn that body back on because I want to draw from it. Okay, I'm not sure what I did wrong the other time, but we're back. We're back on track, man. Okay, so what I want is I want to kind of round that edge a little bit. So what I am going to do is I am going to put a triangle right here, and then I'm going to revolve that triangle around to sort of round that corner a little bit. So I'm going to get the line tool. Okay, and I'm going to come in here and I'm going to click here and then draw out to here, and then I'm going to draw down, and then I'm going to say go from here and draw down to snap to that, and then come up and snap back to that. And then I'm going to hit escape. Sometimes this is kind of annoying. I want to make sure I got it, so I'm going to turn that body off. Yeah, I got a nice triangle there. Okay, I got a nice triangle. Okay, what I also am going to want is I'm going to want that triangle over here. We are going to live dangerously, and we are going to try to copy and paste. And so I'm going to select that, right mouse click, and then I'm going to say copy. Okay, click off of it, right mouse click, and say paste. Okay, let's make sure we got it. Yeah, we got it. For some reason it didn't get that third line, but we're just going to keep going and we will add that third line in there. You know what? We didn't get that third line because there is no third line there. There is this vertical line, but we didn't get it. So I'm going to click L for line. I'm going to click here and click here. And now we have a finished triangle. Okay, escape to get out of that tool. Drag over it. We've now selected it. We're going to say copy. Okay, click off of it. We are going to say paste. Okay, now I'm going to move it to make sure that I got the whole thing. Yes, I got it. And now I'm going to back out, and I'm going to say now move point to point. Okay, you see up here what I'm pointing at? Point to point. And I'm going to say take this point and then have it click to that point. Boom! Look at that. Now I can turn this body back on, turn that body back on to show you. Okay, that's looking good. Okay, now there, I want to do the bottoms as well, so we are going to live dangerously again. So I'm going to, did that get rid of that? Okay, I'm going to, what is going on here? Oh, better say okay, make sure it's still there. Yeah, okay. So now I'm going to select this. I'm going to right mouse click, and I'm going to copy. I'm going to click off. I'm going to right mouse click, and I'm going to say paste. And then what I want to do is I want to flip this around the x-axis 180 degrees. So I'll just say 180, okay, and boom, it did it, 180. And now I'm going to say point to point. I want to take this point, and I want to put it here. Boom. Okay, let's do the same thing over here. Right mouse click, say copy, click off. What did I do? No, I messed up. I said move. Select it, right mouse click, say copy, click off, right mouse click, say paste. There it is. And then what do we want on the X angle? 180 degrees. Okay, boom, there it is. And then I'm going to say point to point, click on this, and then come, it's got a point there, click there. Okay, scared me a second, I didn't think it was going to give me a point. Okay, we're going to click okay, that all looks good. We're going to turn our bodies back on. All right, now the trick is we want to rotate these things around, so let's see if we can do this. I'm going to try to live dangerously. I'm going to see if I can do two at once. That was a little bit too much. All right. So let's see if we can do that. I might ought to turn the body off just to make sure I can select it. All right. So now let's select these two things and rotate them. So what I'm going to do is say create a revolve. And I want this. Okay. Hold down shift and get this one. All right. Now, oh, wait a minute. I need an axis to go around, because you see, I can't go around my y-axis here, so I need to build an axis. So I'm just going to say line. I'm going to come here, let it hover and snap to that point. You see, that's why I put that point there earlier. All right. And then make sure that it's perpendicular. You see how down there I have that little perpendicular? Okay, it's perpendicular. And then I'm going to escape. I'm going to right mouse click and say make it a normal construction line. Okay, so now I've got something that I can work with. All right, now we come back. I am going to now create a revolve, and I'm going to take this. I'm going to hold down shift and select this. Okay, I've got them both selected. And now the axis, I'm going to say which axis? I want that axis. And then it went around. Okay, but what I want to do is I don't want a new body. I want to do a cut. and then I better turn that body back on so it has something to cut. The red means it's going to cut, and then I'm going to say, okay, look at that. All right. Now, I didn't pay a lot of attention if you see about dimensioning that triangle, and you could dimension that triangle to kind of make the amount of roundness that you wanted. Okay. And I was not very specific on that because I just kind of eyeballed it, but it actually looks pretty good. Okay. Let's go back and let's turn this sketch back on and let's turn this body off so it makes it easy to select. Okay, so now I am going to create another revolve. So I click revolve. I say I want that triangle. I hold down shift and I get that triangle. And then I'm going to say select the axis and I want to revolve around the blue axis. It goes around. I'm going to turn that body back on so it knows what to do. And it says, you probably want to cut because you're intersecting. Yeah, okay. Boom, look at that. Wow, this has been a pretty short video, but you have got something that you can 3D print. And I've already printed some of these things. I've got them here somewhere and they just came out great. The things fit and spin around really nicely. And so go ahead, model these things up, send them to your 3D printer and let me know how it works. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video and I hope you guys have enjoyed this series. I know I'm a lot slower and a lot more deliberate, but man, I had so much trouble learning Fusion 360 because the guys that are doing it are so smart and they're so fast and they're like thinking in a world that I can't even think in. And so because it was real hard for me to learn, I think that I can kind of help you guys that are like completely new to this. And I just hope that I'm not going too slow and I hope that I'm not boring you. All right, man, I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. I hope you've enjoyed this series. You guys comment down below. Let me know how things are going for you. Are you learning this? Are you using it? Are you printing from it? Let's try to create a little bit of a sense of community here. If you like the video, think about giving me a thumbs up. It's a huge encouragement. Subscribe to the channel. Share this video with other people. All right. I am Paul McWhorter, and we are going to learn Fusion 360, or we are going to die trying, and I will talk to you guys later.